Hi everybody. So today is the day to start rehearsing your writing. You're going to tell it out loud, and that way you'll be ready to write it a draft tomorrow. So what do I mean by tell it out loud? Well, I think you need to consider your reader, and you want to think about what does your reader need to learn, and decide how you want to tell it in what order, and then just start talking. Tell it to somebody. If there's an adult that will listen, that'd be awesome, or an older friend, or an older sibling. But if not, then tell it to your dog, tell it to your stuffy. You've done this all year long. It's really important to find somebody that you can talk to about your writing so that you can plan it out loud. So here are some things to think about. If you're gonna have a rehearsal for your writing, you're thinking about how you're gonna teach somebody. How are you gonna teach others? And there are three things to consider. What do the others need to learn? What might interest them, and what parts are confusing? So here's the good part. When you're telling it to someone, you can watch their face. And if they begin to go, huh? When you say something, you go, oh, that seems a little confusing to you. Let me explain. Or if they get really excited, like, oh, that's so cool. Then you can think about, okay, so I might make that part a little bit bigger in my writing because that seems to be very interesting. So what do I want my audience to learn? And that really comes from your structure, doesn't it? Do you want them to learn the causes and the effects? Do you want them to learn the chronological order? Or do you want them to learn some three key features in a box and bullets? You already decided that, so that's really this one. What will interest them? What interested you when you were reading about it? When you were learning about the topic, what did you find most interesting? So make sure that you include the quotes that were cool or the little mini stories that were so exciting or maybe some quirky facts that you learned that you want to include in your writing. So make sure you say them out loud to the person you're teaching. And then that confusing part, if you were confused when you were learning about the topic, then it's very likely that your reader would be confused too. So take some extra special time and care in explaining that really fully, saying, I know this might be confusing, let me try to tell it to you so you understand. Sound like a teacher, right? So think about your topic, think about what you want to teach, what might be really interesting and what might be confusing, and spend, you should be able to probably talk for 4 or 5 minutes about your topic. And then if you can't talk for 4 or 5 minutes, it's okay. So go back and learn some more. That's all right. And it's perfectly fine to have your notes open in front of you, right? You don't have to memorize this. It's not a speech. So have your notes out in front of you, but remember not to be reading from them. You want to be talking from what you've learned, from what you know, and then using the notes to help you to keep going. Awesome. So I'm planning on having some small group meetings, and I'll be letting you know about that in the stream part of the Google Classroom, and I'll also invite you personally to a small group. So what I have here, I have Griffin, Sophia, and Kara working on the Yorktown Treaty of Paris, so I want them to get together so they can share ideas with each other, because if we were in the regular classroom, you'd be sitting at a table talking to each other about this topic. And we'll have Solana, Lane, Brooke, Britton, Brody, and Avery get together and talk about the Battle of Bunker Hill. And Molly is studying Valley Forge and Dava, the Declaration. So I'll try to get you two together so that you can teach each other in a Google Meet and help each other to figure out what it is that you want to write so that we can get writing at the end of the week. Alrighty, see you at the meetings. Bye-bye.